This next video is about one of two schools in my hometown, which is situated on the Navajo Nation, but where on the Navajo Nation is what I'm going to keep anonymous and private. Now for the record, my home had the unfortunate story of being used as a Japanese internment camp. It's disgusting and terrible. But with that history, there are tales of ghosts and spirits haunting the school, which is quite sad. I couldn't find any pics of the boarding school pre-new construction, so I am using the new construction pic. Growing up, I always heard about how the boarding school was haunted. Here are three of the stories I was told. Story number one, the mother and baby. The girls' dormitory bathroom has been rumored to be extremely haunted. The tale goes that when a young woman, who was only 16 years old, was pursued by a teacher, she turned him many times, until finally she had had enough and told him no. But to him, this was a bad idea. You see, he was angry, and forced himself upon her. 4 weeks later, she found out that she was pregnant with the teacher's child. He shunned her and lied to the staff about it. The poor girl was so humiliated that she cried about it for months. When the baby was born, the young woman decided it would be best to kill herself and the baby out of fear that her family would shun her. Later that evening, the young mother and her baby went to the girl's dormitory, where she quietly drowned her baby, loving named Brave Star. After the baby was gone, the mother had found a sheet that was hanging, and used that to end her life at the age of 17 years old. The next morning, the dorm mother found her and alerted the authorities and the woman's family. The woman's family, who were heartbroken at the loss of their daughter and grandson, wanted justice. The rapist was very quickly apprehended, after both male and female students spoke up about how he raped this woman. Authorities were upset with the staff and faculty for never alerting them 9 months before. The rapist was trying to claim innocent, but the authorities didn't believe him, and charged him with rape, sexual abuse of a minor and infanticide. The man was sent to prison, for 25 years, where it was rumored that he was murdered in a brawl. I think karma was rightly served to this monster. It was pathetic for him to think he got away with it, but alas, he didn't and is now in hell, where he belongs. Story number two, sounds of laughter, running, doors and bathroom stalls slamming shut and lastly, the smell of rotting flesh. Former staff and students have said that after everyone had gone to bed, they would hear children laughing, or the sound of feet running through the halls of the school buildings. But whenever dorm mothers or male security would investigate the sounds, they found nothing. They would check the students and everyone would be sleeping, even when their names were being called, not one student would stir. It left the staff and security confused. Other incidents also included students being awoken from a deep slumber, smelling rotting flesh coming from the dormitories. The smell was so terrible in fact that it made both staff and students extremely sick. They have searched for the smell, but could never pin it down to one area. The last incident is that of the doors of the building, and stalls in all the bathrooms would continuously open and slam shut with no one being near them. Now you could explain that the building had automatic doors or that the bathroom stalls were just old and needed to be replaced, but that was not the case, as this is takes place 60 to 100 years before the new construction of the school, and with the area having been home to the Japanese internment camp, there could be a lot of angry spirits wanting their voice to be heard. The third and final story, the black shadow of the school. Now, the story goes that when the students have gone for the day or gone back home for the holidays, the security would be walking the grounds to make sure no vandals would show up to break windows and start fires. What they didn't count on is the fact that there were a few shadow creatures said to haunt the school grounds. As told by a former security guard, he was making his rounds when he saw what looked to be a person shrouded in darkness down the hallway. When he called out to them, they ran, so he runs after them, turning down each corridor and trying to keep up with them. When he failed to catch them, he gave up and continued his walk through. What happened next surely might scare you, as the guard continued. He said he heard a growl that shook him and the windows around him. It froze him in place. He said he couldn't exactly move as he was too scared to turn around and look in either direction to find where the intense growl came from. When that feeling of being frozen subsided, the guard started looking for the sound, as did that. A shadow creature stood out in the open for the guard to see it. The guard tried chasing it off. Go on. Get out of here. Go. But the creature didn't budge. When that didn't work, the guard started waking toward the creature, when suddenly, it let out the loudest screech that forced the guard to cover his ears and ran toward him with a fierce growl and red-hot burning coals for eyes. The guard laid down and began to curl up in a tight ball. He laid there for what seemed like hours, waiting to be attacked. When he finally opened his eyes, the creature was gone. He even did another walkthrough to find it and it was nowhere to be found. Guard said he turned in his badge, uniform and a statement, explaining what happened during the shift and told his superior that he was quitting and promised never to step on the school grounds again. No one has seen him since, but his story got out and it's been passed from staff to staff, student to student and family and friends alike. Since the new construction of the school, no stories have been coming out. So maybe the spirits are at peace now, knowing that the bad part of history has been washed away.